We have a winner in the house. She's not only the winner of my Inspired Viewer competition, but she also won her battle with cancer. Don't you touch that dial. I'll be right back to introduce you to winner, champion, humorist, author, speaker, motivator, Eileen Kaplan.
Get ready to find hope. Get ready to be inspired. Get ready to discover your full potential. Get ready for total success. From the Total Success Coach, Princess Bola Adelani.
This is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power, the program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. Yes, I have a winner in the house. And she's the winner, like I said, of my 2014 Inspired Viewer competition, but also she won her battle with breast cancer. It gives me great pleasure to bring onto Inspired Success and introduce you to Miss Eileen Kaplan, an author. She's the author of the book Laughter is the Breast Medicine. She's a humorist, she's a motivator, she's a mentor, and she's a winner. Welcome to Inspire Success.
Well, thank you very much, Princess Bola Adelani. I only know you as actually Bola. I said, poor Princess Bola, she got shortened her name. But this is really an honor to be with you here today.
Oh, you're welcome. You're welcome. It's my pleasure to have you in the house. I'm going to first of all tell viewers about the competition you won and what brings you and how that got you here in the studio. And then we're going to talk about your message, the inspired message that you have to share with the world and about your winning the battle with cancer. And, for viewers, for those who do not know, this year in June of 2014, this TV show, Thanks to You, yes, thanks to you, my viewers, was recognized as the 7 top most watched program on our cable network. And I think it was a milestone, a big deal for me, considering the hundreds of programs that airs on this network, on this cable network. And I felt it was a recognition of not just my work and all of that, but it wouldn't have been possible without the viewers, without my viewers, without you faithfully tuning in and sharing the programs and watching the broadcast and all of that. And I wanted to kind of, extend my gratitude. And so I had a little competition and I wanted to select and honor someone with this award called the Inspired Viewer, Inspired Success Viewer of 2014. And I think it's something I'm going to be doing every year now. And so I asked for people to write in, tell me how many broadcasts they've watched, their favorite shows, how the broadcast has inspired and transformed them. And I said, the winner would have an opportunity to come on the show, have a coaching session with me, and have complimentary admission at my next event. And voila, Eileen wrote in one of the many, many, many that we received. And my team and I looked at it, and yours was very compelling. There were a couple of things that stood out. I think it was number one, the number of shows, the show that particularly spoke to you and your message. And so here we are, me delivering on my promise. We just finished like a coaching session. And then here you are on Inspired Success. And so welcome again. So let's just talk quickly, you know, and so if you missed it this year, next year around this time, you know, be on the lookout for that opportunity to be nominated for this award. Let's just kind of talk a little bit about, you know, the show and your favorite and kind of, I wanted to bring your letter, but I forgot to bring your letter. I wanted to kind of read it to viewers, but you can tell us a little bit more about that. And so, how many shows have you watched and how long have you kind of been following?
I've been watching for quite some time now, and I really thought that the shows that I chose really, really rang a bell with me.
Yes.
Especially the one I chose, I think it was about mentoring.
Yes,
it was
the about mentor mentoring. Effect.
Yes, the
that,
mentor
that
effect.
That aired in yeah. January, yes. Yeah.
The Mentor Effect was really very compelling to me because I am a mentor. I didn't decide to become a mentor. I was chosen by my breast cancer surgeon, actually. One day I received an email from them and they said, "Eileen, we have someone we'd like you to talk to. Would you mind?" So I said, "No, I wouldn't mind at all." So they said, "Eileen, meet Helen. Helen, meet Eileen," by text message, you know, by email and phone numbers, and we both had permission to speak with each other, and that was the beginning of mentoring other women who were going through.
And so how did that particularly speak to you? Is it about how powerful, there is a need
yes.
for even mentors to have mentors
yes.
and just the whole mentor effect, the power of mentoring. Now, what would you say it is the power of
it
mentoring?
It is the power of mentoring.
Yes.
As I wrote in my letter, every mentor needs a mentor.
Yes.
And I've had many throughout my life.
Yes.
And my mother-in-law actually was one of them.
Yes.
She passed away many, many years ago. But she taught me a lot about life and how to cook and how to, you know, get through things.
Exactly.
And prepare for the holidays and all of that. So she, I think, probably was the first mentor in my life.
I know. And there are formal and informal mentors, and mm-hmm. their formal and informal ways of mentoring. And I like the way you did your hand like that, because you know, that is the power of a mentor. That is the mentor effect. Having a mentor serves as a GPS, your navigator. They help you to navigate life, avoid, you know, roadblocks and, you
right.
know, obstacles
right.
and things like that. And
right.
so I like the fact that you did your hand
yeah.
like that,
yeah.
because that is how what really mentors help us to do. They have gone on the path, you know, that we are on, and you know, they have experience, they have, you know, hindsight,
right.
and they can really help us through and to avoid obstacles
right,
and all of
right.
that. So it's really important. You know, I'm a real advocate and believer in mentoring and coaching, and that is part of what, you know, you and I provide you know, as a service to others, and especially to women. And so, yeah, that was that really that spoke to me, that part, that show in particular, and the fact that you selected that as one that was spoke to you the most, because it really aligns with the mission of Inspired Success. Aligns with my mission as the Total Success Coach, you know, and I'm trying to, it's part of my message to the world, to really find yourself a mentor, get a GPS. And it stands, my acronym is someone to guide, position, and support you. And yeah, that was very, very, you know, that touched me. And that was one of the things that kind of stood out there. And that's something for you to think about. If you didn't watch that show, it's on my website. Just go on the video on demand and you will see it there. It was in January, the Mentor Effect, and we'll know about the power and the impact of a mentor. So that's awesome. And then You know, tell us now, you know, about, okay, no, so you have, before we go, I wanted to talk about your next battle that you won with breast cancer. But before we go into that, we just kind of finished a session. Yes. And tell us about, tell viewers about that, about...
Do you want to know about that battle?
Not us.
Do they really want to know? Well, I have to tell you, she is a tough mentor. And you better be ready with your book and your pen clicked open, and because she'll say to you, are you writing that down? But it was truly a very eye-opening eye-opening motivational experience for me. I had never been with a professional mentor.
Okay, you know? Yes.
I'm sure my mother-in-law would say I'm a professional. You know, my mother-in-law would have said she's a professional.
Yes.
But I've never been with a professional mentor. And there are have been many people in my life who have steered me in different directions.
Absolutely.
But it comes to pass that there are many that stand out.
Yes.
And especially what you happen to be doing at that particular time of your life.
Yes.
And so this mentoring session was really a very good one for me.
Good. I'm glad to hear that. If you're just tuning in, this is Inspired Success, and this is Princess Bola. And today I'm in conversation with a winner. You know, I talk to winners. You know that the brightest and the best only, and she is a winner, literally in so many capacities. You know, she's a winner of this competition that I had for my show to select the most inspired viewer. You know, someone who's been following, who's watched many shows, who've been transformed, who has a testimonial from watching the show, you know, because without your engagement of the viewers, I would not have been nominated and recognized for this milestone of being the 7 most watched show. And so she's a winner in that capacity. She wrote in and she was eventually selected. But more so, she's a winner of her battle with breast cancer. And so now let's go to that and let's talk about that and now your message in terms of you now inspiring and motivating and equipping and mentoring others with the tools and the strategies to overcome adversity.
Yeah.
And that has led to your book. I think that is very, very inspirational. That's part of my whole mantra. My whole message is about turning your pain to power and turning your test to a testimony. You know
right.
what I'm talking about.
Right.
And you've done that. And
yes.
So kudos to you.
Oh, thank you.
Congratulations
thank
to you.
And yeah.
and congratulations, really,
thank
truly
you.
To you. So this is Eileen's book, Laughter is the Breast Medicine. And she is a humorist. You'll be cracking up when you're with her. But she has a really positive, powerful message. Before we come to your message, you know, like I said, give me a little bit of a background. Can you believe that this woman is 7+0, like 7 years old, not 70, you know? She looks good, right? Yeah, well done.
Well done. It's the genes.
I know, 7+0, and then I was the 7. That was the other thing. The 7 seems to be the winning number.
7, right.
I was number 7 top most watched show, and then you just turned 7+0. You just turned 7.
Someone told me that 7 is the lucky number.
Exactly.
In Asia.
Really?
So we really lucked out.
Exactly, we are. But so tell me, at what age and when, how many years ago were you diagnosed with breast cancer, and how did you discover this, and how did this kind of, you know, change your life, literally? Because
it really did.
I'm sure that this is what informed this book, this is what informed your new career.
Yes.
You know, as a speaker and a mentor. And so, you know, tell us, so it really literally changed your life.
It did.
And the trajectory of your life.
It did.
So how many years ago?
I am very fortunate to be here 8.5 years past my diagnosis.
Oh, wow.
I diagnosed myself, actually, having been a former X-ray technologist and knowing my body really well.
Yes.
I was doing the breast self-exam religiously every month, and coming up the side of the right boob, I found it.
The dreaded find.
Yeah, the tumor was there. It was definitely a tumor. It wasn't a cyst. Mm. So taking charge, you know, I first called Boston, where I happened to be with my gynecologist at that particular time. Mm. And they said, oh, see your primary care physician first, so you don't have to run to Boston. So I said, fine. So I called them and they said, well, you have an appointment next week. Come in and let the doctor check you. I said, please cancel the appointment. No, thank you very much. And I called Boston back and I was there the next day.
Wow.
They do things rather fast there.
Yes.
They do. So being a tech, a former tech, of course, they squeeze my boob hotter than anybody else's. and then an ultrasound did reveal that what I found was there.
Was
really real. Was really real.
Yes.
So then I had to be referred to my breast cancer surgeon, which was at Brigham and Women's Hospital in Boston.
Yes.
And I met a champion.
Yes.
A warrior. Awesome, a magnificent man.
Awesome. That's so
and
important.
Had a lumpectomy.
A man.
A man. Ooh, yeah. Yeah, right. Arnie was right there watching. My husband was right there watching when he was checking my breasts, you know, and talking to me like I really didn't know what he was doing.
I told you she was funny.
Yeah.
But anyway, so, you know, then they began the process, the whole chemo thing and all of that.
Lumpectomy and finding out that, you know, exactly what it was, which was ductal carcinoma in situ, which is the most common breast cancer.
Okay.
It's called DCIS. DCIS.
Okay. And then, so how long did this process, you know, you eventually had a mastectomy, right?
Yes, I did.
Did you opt to have one?
Yes, I had first the lumpectomy, and then I had chemotherapy.
Uh-huh.
And then when that was done, I had radiation therapy. And it was during radiation therapy that I was checking my breasts,
and
I found a lump in my good breast.
Yeah.
I would have good breast, bad breast. You know?
Wow.
Yeah.
How devastated were you? I mean, that has to be devastating. There has to be all kinds of emotions. You know, just even the diagnosis, the C word is very scary and intimidating.
It can be. It is.
And the whole process, even though, you know, is rigorous and emotionally and mentally and physically draining.
Yes. Yes, it is.
And so, you know, what was kind of the initial reaction? And
well, you know, it was such a tiny little thing. It was way up here.
Yeah.
Between two ribs and my breastbone. And it was so tiny that they even had trouble finding it on an MRI. That's how tiny it was. I was very fortunate. It wasn't metastatic off the first tumor.
Yeah.
And it was just a little old primary tumor sitting there, and luckily I found it extremely early.
Yes. And so the whole process took you from, you know,
from
the
May until December.
Okay, so about 6-7 months, something like that. Yeah. Was that for the both?
For everything.
For everything.
The both came off at the same time.
Yes.
I left them at the same time.
Thankfully.
Really?
And so if you're tuning in again, it's Inspired Success. It's Princess Bola, the Total Success Coach. Today I'm talking to a winner. We're talking about, you know, overcoming adversity and the power tools and the strategies to overcome any kind of adversity. She won her battle with breast cancer. She's an author. She's a speaker. She turned her pain to power and her testimony into a testimony. And she also won my Inspired Viewer competition. Yeah. So in so many aspects, a winner in the true sense of the world. You know, we've been talking about, you know, the diagnosis and the process of discovering the cancer, how long ago, and now I want to talk about, you know, going through that journey. And I think this is where a lot of people need help.
They do.
You know, because I think that one of the first things that really, you know, helps us to win is not so much the battle we're facing, but our attitude, our response, our mindset, how we respond to the battle. I recently saw a very funny poster, and this, I think, was it a horse or an elephant, was tied to a little Winnie chair. You know, it was tied to it. And it just stayed there.
Right.
And the captions said that some of the biggest battles is in our mind. So the real thing that was tying this thing down was so insignificant. But I guess in his mind of this animal, he's thinking more about the rope. He's thinking about what is what is tying him. He's feeling tied. But what is actually tying him is nothing. It's something he could kick off, you know. And so I think that is where the biggest battle is. And so you know, you tell viewers about how you responded to your battle, and what are some of the tools and tips and tools and strategies that you apply that help you to really overcome and conquer this disease.
Yeah.
And then we want to go into kind of, you know, the book and the opportunities that are available, you know, because you're a resource in yourself.
I'm a resource.
You're a bundle of resource for women in general who are going through adversity, and women in particular who are battling cancer. So let's talk about your whole response. Yes, you found it early, but yet you still had to go through all of that, and you went through all the chemo and all that, all the emotional thing, and I guess the prognosis was good, but you still lost your breast.
Well,
and then you know, all of that kind of, the battle is not something you fight alone. Your spouse, your family goes through with you. So what are some of the tips and tools? What was your response? What was the strategy? Humor?
Humor. Actually, my oldest daughter is a social worker.
Okay.
So we cried. And you can't not cry.
Okay.
You're only human.
You're only human. Look into that camera and say you cannot cry and you're only human.
It's okay to cry.
Absolutely.
My oncologist said to me, she said, but be very, very careful not to slip down too far into the abyss that you cannot crawl out.
Exactly.
And this is what she told me all the time.
Absolutely. But it's okay to own the emotion and cry a little, but not to sink down and all of that.
Right.
And so, because part of some of the way we're socialized in our culture and in some spiritual circles, you know, in my faith circle, for example, you know, you're told not, you know, it's like they make you kind of deny the emotion. Don't cry. You know, if you cry, it's a sign of weakness, of a lack of faith.
Right.
But, you know, yes, it is therapeutic.
It is therapeutic.
Part of the process to do cry. But like your oncologist, advised you, don't sink down into that despair. So you cried, you did all that.
But then
What are some of the next steps and practical things that you did?
Practical things are taking charge, knowing basically what you're going to be going through.
Getting the information, the knowledge is important.
Yeah, knowing your family's health history is major important for you because of the genetic backgrounds and whether or not you have a genetic line coming in, like the Ashkenazi from Europe and the black women, and there are all kinds of lines coming into a particular individual. So my oldest daughter said, okay, Mom, we're going to handle it this way. Everything negative, we're going to turn into a positive.
Okay.
It's not an easy thing to do because your mind has control, your mind has control. So it always wants to go to the puddle.
Yes.
But doesn't want to step off the curb, you know. But it was I practiced and practiced myself to change that, and
that is so huge. You practice and practice, and you were intentional about choosing. You chose that I am going to focus
on
the positive. I'm going to focus on the light. That's in the tunnel, the proverbial light in the tunnel.
That's right.
And I'm not going to sink into that despair, and I'm not going to stay there. And so that is another key for you. We do have the choice.
We do.
We do have the power. And so it is not only about you taking charge, any kind of adversity you might be facing. You know, Eileen is saying number one, thing is, own the emotion, cry and whatever, but don't stay there. Take charge, get the knowledge, get information, know about your medical history, if it's a medical related thing, know about the process, the due process of the things you're going to be going through.
Right.
And then the next thing is make a decision.
Right.
Decide that you are not, you're going to overcome and you're going to face the positive. That right. is awesome, Eileen. Thank That's you right. so much.
Oh, you're welcome.
And so, what are some of the things that you used to do and how did you use humor and what are some of the, you know, like practical things you did?
I have had, I've always been on the, a little left to the middle line. You know, I guess I'm a Cancer. Is that that's crazy? I'm a Cancer, and I always say, you know, the crab always yeah. walks a little to the left, a little to the right, sometimes down the middle of the road, and I've fallen and I can't get up. And so my second daughter was the cheerleader. She was saying, okay, Mom, here we go. Yay, team. We're going to get through this. Don't worry about it. We're all here. You'll feel okay.
Okay. Now you've also touched on another strategy, tip and tool, and that is surrounding yourself with positive, motivational people
exactly.
in your life. That
exactly.
is so, so important. And you know, and whether that it be other survivors or thrivers, and whether that would be, you know, just, you know, a community of motivated women,
right.
whatever it is, when you're going through that battle, you could use some external yeah. Stimuli and encouragement,
That's
right?
right?
Absolutely.
That's right.
And it's part of what you were saying, that mentors need mentors, coaches
right.
need, you know, the encourager needs encouragement.
Right.
And so it's just about intentional. You were lucky to have, or fortunate to have somebody in your network, in your family, kind of that was responsible for that.
Mm-hmm.
But not everybody does. And
no.
so you have to intentionally no. seek it out and,
yes.
You know, kind of make sure you're surrounded by people who inspire you and not kind of feed that fear.
Right.
It will feed your faith.
Well, that's, you know, that's a very big issue. You know, many, many women, I mean, 1 in 8 diagnosed every day.
Yes.
And when you hear the word cancer, you've got breast cancer. You know,
it's scary.
And
whatever it is, you know, it may not even be breast cancer,
right.
any kind of adversity.
Any kind
it can
of adversity.
Be. And so these are some of
right.
the things that we need to do.
Right.
Just be intentional about that. And can you believe that our time is up?
Oh, my goodness.
You know, I know already our time is up. And fast forward, after all of that drama and that,
yes.
you know, stage in your life, you penned a book.
I did.
That can be found on Amazon. It can be found on your website. Laughter is the Breast Medicine. It's a good read. I highly recommend it. You know, anywhere books are sold, you can get it. You can
connect. I can order it through Barnes & Noble.
Through Barnes & Noble. Just everywhere.
Through Eileen.
Anywhere. Through Eileen.
Yeah.
Her website. Connect with me and I'll link you up. She's on Facebook like me. She's everywhere.
I'm everywhere.
And, you know, thank you so much for being here. I'm sure you'll come back on some other time to tell us about how you finally, the process of taking that, turning that pain to power and writing this phenomenal book. And I know you're in the process of writing another.
Yes.
And how you launched this new career now and, you know, speaking and inspiring and motivating and transforming and equipping, you know, audiences all around the globe. Well, it's we're not out of words. You know, the princess is never out of words. I'm just out of time. And so I hope I'll see you. If you go to royalproclamations.com, I have so many inspiring programs and events for this fourth quarter to power you forward and cause you to finish 2014 strong. royalproclamations.com. Just so many, many things you can plug into. I want to thank you for tuning in. I want to thank you for being here.
Thank you
Ms.
so much.
Eileen. My
Thank
friend,
you.
It's nice to see you. Thank you again for being an inspired viewer and the honoree of this 2014 competition. This is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, reminding you to keep smiling. Hey, put a smile on your face. Life's too short. You know, keep learning, keep believing, keep networking, keep on keeping on. You're on the winning side. I'll see you next month with another inspiring show. And of course, connect with me everywhere, Facebook, my website, royalproclamations.com. Thank you. God bless. And thank you for tuning in. Bye.